But this morning, we have a special interview for a special person. Please welcome on the line, Tris from Passionate Lives. Good morning, Tris.
Good morning. How are you going?
Good, and you?
I'm wonderful. It's an awesome day today.
It is beautiful. Now, Tris, could you give me a little insight into what Passionate Lives is and what you do?
Yeah, sure. So we facilitate mental health first aid courses. That's the primary thing that we do. But we're also involved in a lot of suicide prevention and mental health awareness raising. And that's really where we're at with the CD that we're putting together.
Awesome. So before I get into your project, could I ask you what motivated and inspired you to create Songs of Hope?
So I've had lived experience of mental illness myself. I was diagnosed with depression and anxiety when I was 12. And I battled that for 10 years. I was agoraphobic for 10 years, so I pretty much didn't leave the house for a long period. I kind of recovered through that, but music has been a big part of my recovery journey. And so when I got the opportunity to be a part of this project where we get 10 songwriters who have got lived experience themselves, we encourage them to write a song about hope. And we're putting it all together. At the moment, we're having a makeover and closure shoot. So the vibe down here in Rockingham is amazing. Everyone's excited about the project.
Awesome. So you have a 10-week project on the way right now called Songs of Hope. Could you explain a little more into what this is?
Yeah, so it's a CD around the theme of hope. So we've got 10 songwriters who all have lived experience from depression, anxiety, psychosis, substance issues, pretty much the works. And we get them together. We've put them through some training. We've done the mental health first aid with them. And yeah. They're all writing a song. We're recording it professionally in a recording studio. And it's going to be a part of the CD with original songs about hope. But we're also filming the documentary around their journey. So we're interviewing them about, you know, their recovery and what they've been through and you know, how they kind of fell into the project. And it's really exciting just to talk to them about how much of a difference it's made. They're all, you know, family now. The youngest is 13, the oldest is 48.
Wow.
So it's really nice to see that everyone's gelled together so well.
Yeah, so your project aims to break down the stigma surrounding mental health. What is the motivation behind that?
Because a lot of, you know, I've worked in community services for 10 years, and a lot of the people that I've worked with who have depression and anxiety, they don't want to get help because of the stigma, because they feel they're being judged. And I think that's a real issue for young people, that they feel that they can't be open about what they're going through. And if you can't talk about it openly, it gets depressed. It's not healthy. So we encourage people to open up and talk about this stuff and without judgment. This is the thing about this project, that everyone is open about their stories and there's no judgment, there's no criticism, everyone gets along.
So what is the long-term goal for not only Songs of Hope, but also Passionate Lives?
So in terms of the CD, there's a lot of people, virtually everyone doesn't want the project to finish. There's talk about forming a band. We're in talks with some organisations to go into schools and things like that to actually launch the CD and the documentary in schools as part of a suicide awareness project.
Wow.
In terms of Passionate Lives, the main thing is just to keep running mental health first aid courses and to go into schools. I've got a daughter who's 8, and her friends, the friends who have signs of anxiety, and I'd love to be able to go to schools and really teach some other kids the tools to deal with depression and anxiety, because it is so common.
Yeah, so a little more on documentary. Can you just go into a bit more detail into what documentary actually is?
Yeah, so we're basically, in the whole 10-week process, we're going to be filming every week that they come in. Yeah. We'll be interviewing them about, you know, how they found projects and their recovery journeys and stories. Hopefully it will be 10 episodes that we'll release.
Wow.
Probably on YouTube, or we'll have a special website as well where people can get hold of it. There's also a live show in May, so we're going to get, we've got a stage in Rockingham, and we're going to get everyone up there singing their original songs. But we're also working on a collaborative song, so everyone will be up on the stage singing the same song together. And again, all the theme of hope, all about the fact that you know, things might be looking bleak now, things might have depression and anxiety, but there is hope out there. A lot of services out there that can help.
So you've emphasised the word hope, obviously, but what does hope mean to you? What's your personal definition of hope?
So basically, you know, when I was 12, I was diagnosed with depression, anxiety, agoraphobia, and OCD. Mm. I didn't believe there was any hope. I thought that that was my future now, that I was about to get used to it. And hope to me says that today might be bleak. You might even be feeling suicidal today, but you know, statistically, a lot of people who even attempt suicide, their life will improve. Mm. It's just a matter of reaching out and getting help and working through some of the storms in your life. But hope says that the world will be better tomorrow, and that's what we've got to cling on to.
That is awesome. Well, Tris, thank you so much for coming on the show. It's been so good having you on. Very motivational as well. Thank you very much.
Thanks for having me. It's been awesome.